Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hello students, I welcome you all to our online teaching academy Ekalaiva. Today for your English period we are going to continue our prose lesson. The Stall Dogs by Sakhi part 3. This is going to be our concluding part. Just a recap of the second part for you. As we all read in the first two parts, an ox had entered the garden of Adela Pingsford. She approaches her neighbor, the artist Ashley, to help her out to drive the ox away. Ashley is an artist who specializes in painting pictures of cows. Ashley also comes to help her out, but unfortunately he is not able to drive the ox out of the house. The ox enters the morning room of Adela Pingsford. Now, how are they going to drive the ox out of her house? Is it going to be an even more difficult process? Let's read and find out. Ashley gets his equipment. What is this? Ashley gets his equipment. Ashley gets his equipment. Let's read and understand. Mr. Ashley, said Adela in a shaking voice, I asked you to drive the ox out of my garden, but I did not ask you to drive it into my house. If I must have it somewhere on my property, I prefer it to be in the garden than in the morning room. Now, we all know that the ox has entered Adela Pingsford's morning room and it is eating up the flowers in the vases. Now, Adela is very upset. She is telling Ashley that if the ox had to be on her property, she preferred it to be on the garden rather in the morning room. Cattle driving is not my profession, said Ashley. If you remember rightly, I told you so at the beginning. Now Ashley is saying that driving cattle is not my profession, and I had already told you at the beginning. I quite agree, answered the lady. Painting pretty pictures of pretty little cows is what you're good at. Now Adela is replying to Ashley. She says that she agrees that with what Ashley says, and she also adds that Ashley is only good at painting pictures of pretty little cows. Perhaps you would like to do a nice one of that ox having lunch in my morning room. So what Adela is saying, perhaps you would like to do a nice one of that ox having lunch in my morning room. So she is saying, you are good at only painting pretty little cows. Maybe you will be interested to do a picture of this ox having lunch in my morning room. Ashley immediately began walking away. Ashley immediately began to move away. Where are you going? Screamed Adela. To fetch my equipment, was the answer. Ashley is asking, Adela asked Ashley that as to where he was going, and he replies that he was going to fetch his equipment. Equipment? I don't want to start using a rope. Everything in the room will get destroyed if there is a struggle. Now Adela is thinking that Ashley is going to bring some rope or something to tie it and pull the ox away out of the house. And she is saying that she doesn't want any rope, because if there is a struggle, her whole morning room will get destroyed. Everything will be spoilt. But the artist marched out of the garden. In a couple of minutes, he returned with a stool and his painting things. Now the artist, he went to his home and he brought all his painting things and his stool. So he has taken Adela's suggestion very seriously. Adela said to just mock at him that maybe you will be interested to make a picture of this ox having lunch in my morning room. But Ashley took that suggestion very seriously and he went and brought all his painting things. Do you mean to say you are going to sit down quietly and paint that animal while it's destroying my morning room? Gasped Adela. Adela was shocked to see what Ashley was doing. So she's asking him that, are you serious that you want to sit and paint that ox having spoiling my morning room? It was your idea, said Ashley, setting his things in place. Ashley also replies to Adela that it was her who gave him the suggestion. I won't allow it. I absolutely won't allow it, screamed Adela. Adela has lost her patience completely and she is screaming that she is not going to let it happen. I don't see that there's anything you can do about it. Ashley is again trying to reply to her that she can't do anything about it. Said the artist, it's not even your ox. Also, you seem to forget that the cook has a headache. This ox doesn't belong to Adela. So he says that this ox doesn't belong to you and the cook is having a very bad headache. She may be just falling asleep and your screaming will wake her up. You should think more of other people. And now Ashley is trying to convince Adela that there's nothing we can do. The ox has to go by itself. And he says that your cook also is having a headache and maybe she might be disturbed by your screaming. The man is mad, exclaimed Adela. A moment later, it was Adela herself who appeared to go mad. Now Adela is very much frustrated and she just shouts that this man is mad. And after that, she herself was going mad. Mad in the sense was very angry. The ox had finished the flowers and the cover of a book. The ox had finished eating the flowers and it had also finished the cover of a book. It has eaten the cover of a book. This made Adela even more angrier. It appeared to be thinking of leaving the rather small room. It was looking here and there and was trying to move out of the room. Ashley noticed its restlessness and threw in some more flowers from the garden to keep it inside the room. Now Ashley was busy painting the ox, isn't it? So he wanted it to stay in the room for some time. So he brought some flowers from the garden and threw it to make it stand in that place. I shall go to the public library and get them to telephone for the police, said Adela, and she left. Now Adela thought that she has to find some other source to help her. And so she says that she's going to go to the public library and call the police to come and help her out. Success. What is this success? Some minutes later, the ox stepped carefully out of the morning room, stared seriously at the human who no longer bothered it with sticks. Now the ox stepped out of the morning room and it turned and stared at Ashley, who no longer troubled the ox. He was just quietly making the picture. The ox also stared at him and then walked heavily but quickly through the garden gate. And it went out through the garden gate. Ashley packed up his equipment and followed. Ashley also packed up his equipment and he followed the ox. It was a turning point in Ashley's life. This picture happened to be the turning point in Ashley's life. How? His amazing picture, Ox in a Morning Room, Late Autumn. He named the picture he painted as Ox in a Morning Room, Late Autumn. He named the picture as Ox in a Morning Room, Late Autumn. Was one of the most talked about works of the next Paris Art Exhibition. It was exhibited in the Paris Art Exhibition and it was the best work. It turned out to be his masterpiece. It was widely appreciated. And when it was exhibited at Munich, it was bought by the German government. It was again exhibited at Munich. Munich is a city in Germany. Munich is a city in Germany. And there, when the exhibition was held, this painting was again displayed and the German government also bought this picture. From that moment, he was well known everywhere as a successful painter. He could paint any subject he liked. He was a very successful painter. He could paint any subject he liked. He didn't have to specialize only in pictures of cows. This picture turned out to be Ashley's masterpiece. It was very widely appreciated and he became a very successful painter. 2 years later, even the Royal Academy was happy to give a great space on its wall to his large painting, African Apes Wrecking a Bedroom. 2 years later, the Royal Academy also gave space for Ashley to paint on its wall, and he made another painting, African Apes Wrecking a Bedroom. Ashley presented Adela Pinksford a new copy of the book The Ox Had Eaten. Now Ashley also tried to pacify Adela. He tried to present the exact book which the ox had eaten and a couple of fine flowering plants for her garden and some nice flowering plants for her garden. But she has never forgiven him. But till date, Adela has never forgiven Ashley. With this, we finish our post lesson, The Stall Dogs. Hope you enjoyed this delightful lesson, children. Thank you very much. To receive our online lessons, please press the subscribe button and you will receive the latest updates. Thank you very much.